THQ.
Hot Wheels World Race was developed by Climax Brighton and published in 2003 by THQ.
Greetings. Because of your extraordinary abilities, you have been chosen to take part in the World Race.
In the World Race, you will take this technology to its limits and beyond.
The cars are equipped with special Nitrox 2 boosters.
The track exists in a different dimension from our own, a dimension you won't see until the race begins.
I call the track Highway 35 because that's where it begins.
Hey, so you wanna play? You'll see my game's on fire, but we don't play the same game. You'll see I'm greedy for speed, and neutral means nothing to me. So if that's your desire, we'll get along famously. But one thing I like to lead, I light 'em up before the motor starts. I go so fast that I can never stop. Look under the hood, but you don't know what I got. I'm a moving violation, baby. Hot, 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 hot. I light 'em up before the motor.
Let's do a league first. I kind of just really like the Overboard 454, so we're just going to do that one. Points needed to continue 3, positions needed to continue 5, races remaining 6. Okay. Gonna have to figure out the controls, because the ones on the launcher do not save. Okay, I'm pushing buttons. Oh, so K flips me back. W and S are forward and backward and brake. J and L are how I steer. This is wild. Haven't found parking brake. Oh. On that camera. I think I got myself closer to the car somehow. There it is. I've got all this booze. Now, only if I could use it. Only I could use it. Okay, space is handbrake. That's good. That wasn't good. I had the race in the bag, and then I just threw it away. Oh, look at that. better the second time. So D is nitrox. Satellite City. I just found and watched through the this movie with my kids, and that's kind of why I wanted to play it next. Shortcut? Hey. Picking up all the sonic rings and it's a waste. Why are you so fast? Oh. What's that do? I don't remember what that does. Hey, I want those. I guess I can't, you can't spin people out. Don't know what the hot wheel does. I like how the boosters correct you, your car to aiming straight. Vapor City. Is this just Cloud City with clouds, like actual clouds? I think this is the race I remember the most. Because I remember that. I remember these loops very clearly. That's just what comes to mind when I think of this game. Because I didn't play this game very many times. Because I think I had troubles getting... Oh, no. I think I had troubles getting it to work. A lot of the time. So the very few times I played it, this race is what? comes to mind. Oh. It's a really short stun jump, which is why I'm hesitating to actually do anything on it. The E-brake around that corner is not a good idea. Tesla's Cube. I don't remember there being a track in the real world. So there's a whole, that whole thing being that it was all in a different dimension. Remember that? You remember that? You know? There wouldn't be a track in the real world. Should not have landed that. Jeez. Oh, so that left-right thing changes. Super stale. I don't get anything from that because I've done it before, I guess. I really like that car in fourth as well. Well, second now. Because of Hot was Velocity X. It was blue in that game. Well, I guess that's the reason I like the car I'm driving too, because it was a blue car with white stripes and Hot Wheels Velocity X. We're in space out. I don't think getting a big lead on the first lap actually does anything for me, because they just catch up to make it seem more challenging. So if I just wait and do whatever into the last lap, then boost near the end, right? I'm not going to do that because I don't want to risk it, but stale. Damn, right behind me. Forgot which button was to look behind me, and I don't want to change my camera view on accident. Should have saved that nitrox, because I don't think I'm going to build up enough before the... Yeah, before right here. That's fine. Don't drive the truck is what I'm hearing. Don't drive the truck. Actually, I might recognize this track equally as Vapor City. I think so. What are you doing up there? Oh, this is open now. I didn't mean to do that. I also don't know how they get so high. Am I supposed to hit the nitrox at the same time as the jump? Like this? Oh, yes. Okay. Oh my. This 200 is my top speed. It's kind of weird. This is in the movie. The top speed is a little over 300. I don't care if it's stale. I don't need it. I'm saving my boost. How's that still closed? Do those wheels unlock? Do those unlock the routes? Oh yeah, so you grab the wheel and then unlock the thing up there, so then this wheel must unlock something else too. That would make sense. That would make some sense. Congratulations, you've completed Rookie League. You're ready for the real competition now. Try Veteran League. Emerald Crater. Decided to use a different car, just for some variation. Because it had some different specs on it. I think this one's a little bit faster, but it doesn't accelerate as fast. So, hopefully I don't hit as much stuff, and I should be better off. It also occurred to me that the car I was driving overboard 454 for Taro. Not the same car that it was in the movie. Pretty sure it was a Plymouth Roadrunner in the movie. Oops. But I'm also pretty sure they swapped out almost half of the cars that they used in the movie to different cars in the game. So like if you buy the toy, it's going to be whatever they used in the movie. But in the game, I guess, I don't know if modeling was just too hard, or why they didn't use them. This car's not bad. Oops. Sweet, we unlocked Vulture. That was a car. That was the car I wanted to use. Is this a cruise ship? We're on a cruise ship. We're on one of those fancy cruise ships that goes underwater, I guess. I don't know if I mentioned it already in this video, but this Hot Wheels car, Vulture, was still one of my favorite Hot Wheels cars due to Hot Wheels Velocity X, the game. Missed the jump, now I'm way behind. If you don't want them to pass, just cut them off. Oops. It's fine. Stale. Don't remember what I did. I don't know how they always get up top every single time. They can't have that much boost. I wonder if there's something fancy I'm supposed to do to get up there. Yeah, no idea. Oh no. It's a fine line between getting a good e-brake for a turn and then spinning out. Thought we'd play with the title car for at least once. We can't go up there. Oops. Never mind. Sounds like they unlocked that, and they're going to be in front of me now. Maybe not. I think I might have figured out how they jump that far every time. If I'm right, I think it's that you have to fill up your nitrox, and once you do, you could use it whenever you're on the jump, and you retain it as long as the trick you do on the jump isn't stale. And if it is stale, then you just, you know, it uses it up. So let's try. I don't think I've done left. Oops. Never mind. So we'll take the scenic route here. Use it on the jump. Go left. And if you land it. Oh, never mind, I'm wrong. No idea. Get out of here, Taro. He's so much faster than me. Why are you so fast? Got that off the last second. I think that was one of the first races I didn't get first on. Try not the Zodiac car this time. Oh, geez. Oh, are we coming back on the same road? Is that a track above the head? Taro was just on the billboard. A little spooky. Died it. Okay. Ow. Oh, we do come back on that same road. Saving the Nitrox again this time for, well, that jump right there, I guess. I think those clown masks give me a faint reminder of the clowns that are in Marvel Ultimate Alliance in the arcade zone. I'm glad they got that, because I have no idea how you get Nitrox two times in a row like that. And I missed that one again. It's a quick way to last. Stale. Oh no. Pulled in person though. By a half a second. Pick so fast this time, this car. It's got a high top speed but a slow acceleration, so if I don't hit anything I should be good. I had at least, oh my goodness. The gravity is weird. Well, that's not good. Well, that's not good at all. I think I had two or three of the actual diecast of this car. But I think they were... I think they were white. White with a red or blue design or something on them. Well, thanks for the boost, I think. Take me just to slow down. I think I picked the slow route. Maybe not. Like they're the same. And these car wars were cool because that engine, you see the blower in the back. They opened up. The diecast cars actually hinged and opened up. And you rough, if you're rough on them, then you lose the gate. I hope that doesn't happen on the last lap. Is that Twin Mill? And the Twin Mill was one of the cars. Is it? It looks like it. I think it is. Definitely have a lot of tracks in this that seem to be themed similar but not really related to the movie. Like, was the city that they got to, Hot Wheels City, was that what they called it? Was that on water? It was an island, wasn't it? Like a floating city? It wasn't underwater. Actual air on this one. The other tracks suction you to the ground. Don't mind this car. I'm disappointed about the lack of storyline in this game, though. It's a lot of missed opportunity for dialogue, additional story, or maybe even the same story. That'd be cool. Oh, it gives me a full boost even though I already used it. For some reason, this mid-game music reminds me of a song in the Spider-Man 1 game, but I'm not really sure why. Some penguins here. Is that a prototype? It's like they're driving one of the prototype cars. I think it's a street breed car. Let me up here. Just giving away a boost. Just passing up a boost. I forgot the name of the car, man. Is it? It's Power Pistons or something similar, isn't it? You listen to the Street Breed song? Wait, does that mean I have two? Hold on. No. But that blue light on the Nitrox indicator meant that I had two boosts, but that's not a thing. Stale. Thank you, somebody else. A lot of claws and like, is that a digging apparatus? This is Ice City and they're digging up rocks, I guess. Oh, that was a Street Breed logo on those rocks back there. Isn't the, wait. So if each map is themed, and like the lava theme maps are obviously Scorchers. Why is the street breeder about, like, talked in the movie about navigating cities? And if the point of a street breed car is to navigate cities, why then would they be? I mean, it's called Ice City, but why would they be in a mining facility on a middle of nowhere ice island? Was it Wave Rippers? Is it the Wave Rippers theme song? Wave Runners, Wave Rippers. Yeah? Because it seems faintly themed after Wipeout, the song Wipeout. We'll have to see if there's any of their logos around. But if that's the case, then it doesn't really... I mean, there's some waterfalls, but that's not related. Super stale. Not even just kind of stale. Oh, jeez. Wait, how am I in sixth? What happened? Oh, they're there. So that was a league race, followed by every other available track. So let's do a challenge to finish it off. First challenge four to go. Grab pickups to fill your Nitrox 2 bar to the top, and Nitrox 2 boost past the cones. Press boost to Nitrox, pick 2 boost. So I gotta grab pickups and then boost. Okay. Oh, it's 15 seconds. Next challenge. So that just meant we had to get there within 15 seconds, and if we didn't boost, we wouldn't. Nitrox 2 boost jump to land on the high shortcut. Is this a tutorial? Pull stunt in the air and land it. Keep directional button held. No, this is just a tutorial. Perform a button combo during a stunt and land it. Press the action buttons shown at the top of the screen during a stunt. Accelerate camera. Oh, okay. Accelerate brake, handbrake camera. This one's going to take some effort. Because I don't know if I can. Accelerate. Missed it. Accelerate camera. Accelerate camera. Is that not? Which one's the camera? It's Y. Accelerate camera. I hit Y. I meant change camera, not look behind you camera. Got the crazy flames. Fifth and final challenge. Handbrake around the corners and get past the force field. Flaming wheels open force fields. Would have failed if I didn't e-brake? Congratulations, challenge mode complete. All that remains in single player are quick race and time trial, which seem self-explanatory and take place on all the tracks we've already done, so I will not be doing them.